Right, we're gonna need some help here with our first initial list. Let's go. So, we have a list here. We're gonna be playing some blue-black Grave Titan. This is a revisit. Now, I've already taken a few of the YouTube suggestions and applied those. I have a couple things I'd like to try, though, too, that were mentioned on the stream. So, let's go over what's kind of changed here since the last time. You didn't share anything with me, Dylan. All right, so what has changed? So YouTube suggested I have less dark slick shores. So we've taken those and made them watery graves. That was the straight suggestion. Minus two, plus two. Minus two, plus two. We had some remands. We have mana leaks here, and we have snapcasters. There used to be a remand here. Drown in the Lock has been upped in place of that. And Dylan, if you've sent me something, cool, but if you haven't, you haven't. See, nothing sent. Bam. All right. Back to bad to here. So, Remand is not here anymore, but I did like the Spreading Seas. I like that cantripping. I like the fact that we're not in red, but we can kind of play a little bit of that Blood Moon style, where we remove some of the cards that, not removing cards, we're making it difficult to cast cards. So we have that. Drown the Lock's been upped in place of the Remand, and actually a Singleton Cryptic. Now I'd kind of disagree with the removal of the Cryptic, but that was mentioned, I believe, twice. So maybe people have a reason for that. I don't see a reason for that. I think you want to hit as many Cryptics. But we've dropped one. The other thing that was mentioned quite frequently on the stream was actually running a Torrential Gearhulk. Now, if you did check out our Grixis Titans list, I might put that link if I remember up in the top here. But if you remember that, Frost Titan was actually one of the more dangerous Titans for our opponents to run into. Inferno Titan was a bit of a joke. Also, I think we only cast that once. Grave Titan did some serious work, but it was Frost Titan. So I've actually plopped a Frost Titan into the sideboard as well. So we have it here. Whether we keep it or not, we'll see. Now, a few things that I'd like to play is this Jace Mirror Mage. Now, I've thought about, hey, we have Jace Mind Sculptor. Once we get that down, we're obviously this blue-black control list. We're just trying to get to our Grave Titan and finish the game. Jace Mirror Mage kind of interested me because it's at 5 mana with a kicker, can be two Jaces. Now, I'm probably not going to use the draw element as much, but I could. Four basically gets this of the deck. I believe it would get a land. But it gets this side of the deck. Let's see here. Would it get a land, draw a card, remove a number equal to convert mana cost? Yeah, just convert a mana cost. If you happen to get Grave Titan, Torrential, or Consume, Jace goes away. If you get any of these, Jace goes away. But if you get any of this lower end stuff, it stays around. To me, though, we've got an interesting gap. We go from two to heavy fours, and really we go kind of to six. We're like two, four, six. Jace and Liliana are the gap there, and Consume the Meek is the gap on this side. To me, putting Jace on kind of the fifth spot kind of makes it interesting. I just want to run it. Now, by adding Jace and by adding Torrential Gearhulk, I've run into a problem. My problem is that I have 62 cards. So, Twitch, would we like to cut something, or do we run 62 card special? You'll notice Thoughtseize is completely void here of being anywhere in our list. I kind of liked actually the Duress package because you don't take as much damage and you can take non-creature, non-land cards, which is pretty sweet. That's basically why we would be bringing Thoughtseize in. So I actually kind of like the nod to playing a Duress. But blue-black, Grave Titan. Having the Singleton Grave Titan and not the Torrential Gearhulk gave us only one win condition. By doing it this way, we kind of have two. Maybe I'm supposed to put Frost Titan in here and then move something from the main board to the sideboard. I've thought about Cling to Dust, this card could be a sideboard along with some other stuff, and then just do the double Titan. What do we think? We're kind of talking through this. What do we think? You think just cutting one push and one seize? We could do that. We have added Drown the Lock, and that's a good thing that you bring up, Stompy. By adding two more Drown the Locks instead of Remands, we're not gonna like draw a card, but we have more interactions. So I could see a Fatal Push being cut here for that potential Drown the Lock add. I don't mind a drop of a Seize as well. Seize is kind of weak against some of the red decks that we've been seeing frequently. So I could just cut these two and say, you know, let's go. If we like that, drop, they won't be in the sideboard. I'm putting them here just to have for a second. But if we did that, I can keep the Torrential Gear Hulk. I like the idea when, like, say, I don't know, Cling to Dust isn't very good. We can get in like a Damnation Kalidus, maybe the Frost Titan. We can bring an Aether Gust. We can adjust kind of the lower side here. We might be pulling Jace out frequently, but I'm good with a Spreading Seas and Fatal Push cut and doing this 75. If we think this is good, we'll hit the run button and get going. You used to love Grave Titan. Why don't you love it still? Grave Titan's cool. Really, the final question I probably have is Torrential Gear Herc or play the Frost Titan main? If I played the Frost Titan main, I almost want to change a Dark Slick Shores to a random cavern. I think the Gear Hulk's just more interesting, though. Gear Hulk could Mana Leak, it could Cryptic, Mystical Teachings, it could Drown the Lock, it could Cling and Fatal Push. Trade in for the Noxious one. Enters the battlefield, may destroy another target creature. If a creature is destroyed this way, you gain life. It's kind of an interesting one to have. Almost more interesting than the Frost Titan, but I think I like Torrential here. This is where I'm a little bit hesitant that I've only got two Cryptics. But I think black-blue, or blue-black, has this need to be more on the Grixis side of things. If you played blue-white, we'd be doing more Cryptics and counters. By being black, I think you need to be more destructive, and that's where Drowns, Fatal Push, and Damnation come in. With all of this being said in a rather long, little-winded deck tech at the beginning here, let's go ahead and begin playing Magic. I think we've got what we want. Good enough for at least a revisit some of the small changes. We don't want to go too far beyond our changes from the previous league. We don't want to change 10, 15, 20 cards. You're going to end up changing to a different style of deck. I like the Consume the Meeks. I think the Damnations are good. I want to run into Jund. I want to run into the Red-Black Prowesses and other creature decks. I don't want to really run into Uro, but we have answers for it. Let's go match one here. Let's play some Magic. Couple Cryptics here, an Opt and an Inquisition. The hand seems fine. I think I can go ahead and keep this. We'll lead with Flooded Strand, Fetch Shock, and Inquisition here. A little aggressive with our mana, but I think that's okay to lead things off. Keeping in mind we have more of these Watery Graves. All right, we have a Bone Crusher Giant, a Lightning Bolt. We've got some Arbor Elves as well. Based on seeing what we have here, I'm going to go ahead and take the Bone Crusher Giant. It's a little harder for us to deal with. Just because they have two Arbor Elves doesn't mean I really care about that. They'll play Forest and Arbor Elf. So we're going to play against some sort of Ponza list. This seems relatively reasonable to be doing. We'll play Polluted Delta on the off chance that my opponent will have Blood Moon. We'll get going. What's up, Odysseus? Things are going all right. I got a bit of, didn't say it before, but since you've asked, I got a little bit of a headache. My neck feels a little tight today. It's probably still recovering from our back funds. All right, Windswept Heath played, Utopia Sprawl was drawn. We're going to tap untap this forest, which is already there. What are we gonna do? Harbor Elf. Utopia sprawls again. So we know what's left here. They actually goof up just a little bit, not getting the extra green. They untapped before they were supposed to. Beanball already making us hydrate. Here, we'll draw this. I'm gonna go ahead and fetch now. Not gonna worry about double black just yet. Ooh, I kinda, you know what? Just because they are Blood Moon possible, I'll take the extra island there. All right, let's go ahead and do a draw with Cling to Dust, just see if there's anything else. Damnation's not bad. Go ahead. All right, pretty simple turn here. Not too afraid of anything just this once. Let's go. We've also are trying this without the cap on the top. We'll see if that matters. Stomping Ground tapped, opponent targets with Arbor Elf. We'll see if they play their other one. I do like splitting like they've done because we do have Cryptic Commands to bounce these. All right, we've got some Mystic Sanctuaries here. I think we'll just play Island past turn, really. I could use my Cling to Dust, but at this point it's only getting to gain me life. Not really what I want to be doing. Yeah, just small things, Odysseus. We've got a new chair. It's sitting in the other room. I'm giving it time to quarantine. Anything we get, we quarantine for just a little bit in the front of the house. Gotta be safe. Arbor Elf's attack here. Let's see what else my opponent's got going on here. Stomping Ground shocks it in. Cloythus, well. Counterdraw seems pretty decent here. Counterdraw, please. Ooh, Snapcaster. All right. Now, Liliana. Well, I do need another black source. We haven't changed the number of black sources we have, by the way. Let's do Mystic Sanctuary, and let's put an Opt on top. We can do this because I can Cryptic counter draw and then use that opt. If they just let me go to picking that opt up, that's probably fine too. All right. Opponent attacks us for a pair here. Again, I'm not too worried about just a few Arbor Elves here. Got lots of life total to work with. Chandra's a big no. Let's, I think counterdraw is still fine here. Counterdraw, we know it's just bolt, so we'll go ahead and opt now. There's another black source. Doesn't come into play untapped, though. Let's go ahead and bottom this. There we go. What's up, bunny? Creeping Tar Pit. I wonder if this is worth a Liliana being played here. It may not be. 2, 3, 4, 5. It may be just worth it to Mystic Sanctuary, put Cryptic on top here. And then anything that's bothersome, we'll do Snap Cryptic. And then we can worry about maybe blowing up the world next. Lots of time here. We're only at 11. Opponent attacks once again. Okay. By snapping and crypticking too, we'll have a blocker for this Liliana. Attempts to pillage here. Well, I kind of want my black mana here, so snap, cryptic, and then we have another cryptic. Not sure we'll use it immediately, though. We'll see. Trying to figure out the Grixis fairies. I wish you well on that adventure. Counter draw. Keep our black source. Thank you very much. So we got this cryptic. I can go get basic swamp here and then use 1, 2, 3 and still have cryptic up. And then I have a blocker for this Liliana as well. Looking pretty good here. You're the spice bunny. All right, pretty easy kill here on the Arbor Elf. Onward we go, cryptic in hand, and they know about it. Looking pretty decent here. Obviously no attacks, because I don't want Arbor Elf to come in and then them just use a lightning bolt here. And I want them to, if they have a second lightning bolt, have to use that. We'll see what they do here at end step. I'm feeling like we're pretty far ahead now, even though our life total is low. We have 4 cards in hand and we know that their last card's a lightning bolt. And the lightning bolt just doesn't really scare me. Perhaps I should be scared. We can always use Cling to Dust to gain a little bit of life if we're concerned once we untap a little bit here. All right, there's a Bloodbraid Elf. Pretty good card. Into an Arbor Elf. 2, 3, 4. So they have a lightning bolt left. See where they want to go here with the attacks. They decide to attack everything at me. What if I picked up Snapcaster here? Like, pick up Snapcaster, draw a card. What if I bounced Arbor Elf and drew a card? That'd be kind of cute. Rather pick up this land. It's probably fine. Let's go ahead and draw one deeper here. This will give them an opportunity to use this bolt if they'd like to. I can kill one more creature and leave up Drown the Lock pretty easily here. Returning this to hand, I can put the Cryptic back on top if I want to as well. It's really important that we just know this last card. So this will be the bolt. This should hit upstairs. We're at 4. All right. Gives me some screen real estate as well. Thank goodness. All right. Oh. Well, this goes up. I guess we're playing that, right? I guess we're playing Grave Titan. And Mystic Sanctuary to go ahead and pick that Cryptic back up for next turn. That looked pretty good. Good luck, opponents. I don't think there's a card that they can do right here, right now that could save them. Get 2010'd. Glorybringer? Ah, yeah, Glorybringer could do it. Yes, you are correct. Oh my gosh, chat's just like, here, let me curse you right now, Glorybringer. Luckily, I saw that after my opponent drew. No, Heath is not Glorybringer. My opponent is reconsidering their queue for this league right now. Why do you have Grave Titan? Why are you playing blue-black? Nice. All right, blue-black against some Ponza. Like Aethergust, I do like this negate. Frost Titan's interesting, Kalidus is interesting, Damnation's pretty interesting. More or less everything else is kind of like a hit or miss here. Cling to Dust doesn't really have to hit anything, so Cling can probably leave. Consume the Meek's a bit interesting in that it gets quite a few things, but it doesn't get like Bloodbraid Elves. It wouldn't get Glorybringers. It may be worth swapping this for the Damnation. What's the appropriate emote for this win? Yeah, it's not Blood Moon, that's for sure. this Jace feels a little bit awkward for this matchup. Ult Lily faster. Spreading Seas actually seems pretty decent here. Let's go ahead and keep that. I think it's consume Jace and Klings for negate Aethers at minimum. I like these four things. I'm wondering what I should maybe do for these. What do we think? Liliana is actually very good in this matchup. It's going to be really awkward if they get a Coithus down. It's going to be really difficult for us to beat. Kalidus is probably the first thing to bring in, and then like Damnation. Spreading Seas can be very good. My opponent can play Arbor Elves and put Utopia Sprawls on them, and then I can Spreading Seas them, and they don't even get to untap them anymore. They're actually reasonably okay. Maybe not worth three. Perhaps I could do one Spreading Seas out and one Damnation in, but we need to then be super careful about our lands, keeping in mind that I have two swamps here. The other thing is Spreading Seas can help us in the case of a Blood Moon. So I kind of want to keep this Spreading Seas. I honestly think I actually want to get rid of a Jace. Maybe it's Mystical Teachings, actually. Let's do Mystical Teachings. Five Color Titans next? No. Let's not get too crazy here. All right. The hand's interesting. It's going for him, and how are you? We'll keep. This will be interesting. We could get turn two Blood Mooned, which will be awkward. You think the Torrential comes out? I think Torrential is just a repeat on my Damnations in the yard. My opponent mulls to four cards here. That's really not great for them. Best thing to see here would be Fetch. And, you know, just Arbor Elf or something. And I say Fetch because that'll help turn on our Drown the Lock a little earlier. Doesn't one of the Ponza spells also ruin artifacts? Pillage? I'm not worried about a Pillage on a Torrential Gearhulk. If that's what's happening and that's all they're playing that turn, then go for it. When I'm Torrential Gearhulking and Damnation, it's not gonna matter. All right, what if Foothills does enable Drown the Lock on this one mana spell? If it's Arbor Elf. It is Arbor Elf. Fatal Push off the top? No Fatal Push, but Inquisition's probably the best draw for us. Double check there's no Pillage or Blood Moon. So there's a Blood Moon. We have an Arbor Elf that I don't care about because of Liliana, so we'll just steal the Blood Moon here. If I get a non-untapped land here, then I will just not worry about Creeping Tar Pit. We have several decks there. It's gonna be the blue-black Grave Titan revisit list. Arbor Elf has been played. All right. Creeping Tar Pit needs to come in here so I can hit Liliana on curve. I'm not worried about three mana. I'm not worried about four mana. Opponent's lacking that red mana. Perfect example where Spreading Seas could be very beneficial. In for some damage, my opponent comes. Pow, pow, double. Island, and we're just gonna Liliana them. This Liliana is probably game ending. My opponent has one card in hand. If it's a red card, they're not playing that card. I'm about to take both their Arbor Elves back, and then I have the Drown the Locks to defend. We'll get the Torrential Gearhulk, or we have Snapcaster, Drown the Lock. This game is just about done. Only works on instants. Well, we'll get to that. Instant cards, huh? Instant cards, huh? Awkward. I survived the tortillas. I did. All right. This was a bit of a non-game. A little bit of a non-game there. Let's continue on and carry on forward. We did D20. If you're wondering what D20 is talking about, then you're probably not following me on Twitter, or you haven't opened your Twitter app, which I commend you. Twitter is It's rough. All right, that was a bit of a non-game there. Yeah, apparently Gear Hulk is on instants and sorceries. Not, or just instants. So Fatal Pushes work, Drown the Locks, Mana Leaks, Ops, Cryptic Commands, Mystical Teachings, Consume the Meek. All right, so it doesn't hit Damnation. We'll hear about it in YouTube comments. Fluffy, dumb, doesn't know what Gear Hulk does. Unfollow, unsubscribe. Terrible player. All right, let's play first. Always a good thing. We'll keep this. A little bit sketchy, but Drown the Lock plus Mana Leak's gonna send us the distance. You deleted the Twitter back in October? Smart. I use it mainly to post that I'm going live, but I figured that I could be a little bit, I won't say personal, but a little more like inner. Oh. Leyline, eh? All right, well, we got an interesting one here. Oops All Spells is what it appears to be. Let's go ahead and leave ourselves with a Mana Leak up. Looks good. Creeping Tar Pits next. Drown the Locks are looking a bit iffy. Turn one Fluffy Blood Moons. We try sometimes. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and Mana Leak this. We gotta start filling the graveyard here for the Drown the Locks. And if I have the Mana Leak in the yard, I can snap Mana Leak potentially. Cling to Dust is kind of interesting. All right. Cling to Dust is a bit interesting. I'm not sure I'll be firing that off anytime soon. Because it shrinks what's going on over there. Maybe I Cling to Dust myself here so I can hit card. You know what? Let's cling ourselves here. We'll pick up a Fatal Push, which is no good, and we have an Opt. Interesting. Let's go ahead and Opt here in case I do find a Creeping Tar Pit. Bottom the Cryptic Command, find a Damnation. All right. That's a whole lot of nothing. We need to find that next land. Drown the Locks are looking bad, unless my opponent starts with some sort of, Something that's like cheaper than this. Spy here. I don't think there's anything I can really do to interact with our opponent. I'm glad I have counters. We'll just say that. So Narcomoebas, we have the Creeping Chills, we have the Vengevine package. Should have saved the Cling. Right now, Cling would do nothing here. Right? I guess you're saying save the Cling here so that I would have had it on the Salvage Titan. Maybe that's true. Maybe I got greedy. I could have also snap clinged if I didn't use the opt. I shouldn't have used the opt. All right. We got greedy looking because I knew I had Creeping Tar Pits. What I should have done is just hung onto the Cling to Dust. All right, so Ashiok and Nile Spell Bombs can come in for this matchup. Duresses are okay as well. I like a Negate here. I don't mind Ceremonious Rejections. Got these Fatal Pushes that I can pull out here. Consume. It's not good. Torrential Gear Hulk is a maybe. Mystical Teachings is too slow. Damnation's too slow. Jace Mirror Mage is too slow. Honestly, Liliana's not very good either. Yeah, I think this is what I've got to do. Counters. I really just have to counter what they go in all in on. I like the Torrential Gearhulk in case we get up to that much mana, and then I can counter something else with it. All right, we're going to submit. Everything that's more the sorcery speed just doesn't feel like it's going to do it. Yeah, I should have held the Cling. We learned. We learned we'll get better. Hold Cling for forever. Hold the Clings for forever. Wasn't there only three Vengevine in the yard? Drown one, chump the snap, pray for the land that was on top, and then Damnation. Thought I saw four. I thought I saw four. I could have been wrong. There we go again. We'll keep. All right, let's see if we can play better here. You might be correct, Graeus. Maybe I totally misplayed that, and you guys could land me with a punt, but you're all so nice that you would never, ever consider punting Fluffy. Punting Fluffy's illegal. Half watching. Even my mods don't watch anymore. Thought sees me, huh? Huh. I don't think I like this happening. I don't know, this feels like a good way to check my hand to see if they can go off, and if I can keep that a mystery here, I feel better. Play this Mystic Sanctuary tapped and pass turn here, leaving Drown the Lock open. Not that it hits a whole lot at the moment. Talisman here. Let's go ahead and opt in case I find a Ceremonious Rejection. I'll take the land. It's rare that I'm going to find the Ceremonious Rejection there. This looks pretty decent, though, that I can have a Cryptic Command up next. What do you do here? Do you Inquisition and leave yourself with a Drown, which is only 2 mana, or do you leave yourself with a Cryptic Command? That's true, you can rewatch the YouTube video. What if I just stop putting them up there? What if I stop putting them up there? Probably just a Cryptic, I agree with you, Zale. I mean, if my opponent has Pact of Negation, I wasn't gonna beat it anyway with 4 mana. You all know I wanna be super greedy here. So this is a counter draw. See what happens. All right, we survive for another day. I can Inquisition and see whether or not I want to... Ooh, Negate's not bad either. So I can Inquisition here and see if I want to leave anything crazy up. All right, so there's 2 Creeping Chills. So theoretically, take Thunder City. I should be safe to play Jace. If they get a Spy off the top, my Drown Lock doesn't stop that either, so they'd have to get exactly under City Informer. I just took one, so there's 3 out of 51 cards. I could even uptick with Jace here, because we don't have to always brainstorm. So Jace, uptick, check it out. Thoughtseize. I probably just give them the Thoughtseize, right? Sure, Here you go. Take my Gear Hulk, but I know you won't combo. Should I put the Thought Seize on the bottom of their library? No. Have a Thought Seize. We're gonna Fate Seal this person to oblivion. We're not even gonna touch Brainstorm. Everyone's using Jace incorrectly. Silly people. And if they steal one of these two and I top deck a land, easy mode. It's a lock, exactly. My opponent hard cast a Creeping Chill. Alright, we top deck a Snapcaster, which looks good. We'll take a look at the top of their library. You can have that. Good luck. Oh, I almost feel like I should just negate the Creeping Chill if they play it. Bam. Alright, we'll let that resolve. We hit our land here. Continue to look at the top. Nope. You can have that one. Go ahead. Oh, it's over. We're working our way up to greatness. Using Jace the proper way. What you gonna do, opponent? Yep, we know about that land. Yep. Go again. Up to 11. You can have a creeping chill. That's fine. Go ahead, chill me. Give me the chills. That's fine. All right, I'm down to 6. No fear. No fear, everyone. What else you got on top? Nah, you can keep that. Have a Pentad Prism. We get to ult Jace. They can have this. Go ahead. Nice Pentad. Nice. J-Salt? J-J-J-J-Salt? Boom. Boom. Have one card. Good luck. Good luck. A little surprised we're still playing this out, but... You know. We gotta go to game 3 at some point. Library go brrr. Yeah, did you hear the sound? Occasionally sounds come through. Alright. Do we want to change anything? I don't think so. I don't think I want the Liliana. I think what we have is just completely fine. We'll just submit. I don't think my opponent's trying to do too many things that are busted to us. Oops All Spells has dialed it back one or two small notches here from going super all in. Now, we don't have a counterspell too immediately here. I do have the Inquisition. My opponent's mulligan to 6. I think I'm going to go ahead and lean heavily on the Inquisition to make my opponent hiccup here. My opponent's mulligan to 5 as well. Following this up with potentially Opt will be nice as well. I get my draw step to find some counters. All right, so a little turn timber here, probably sideways. Sideways it goes. Play our watery grave here and do an inquisition. Check out what's going on. A couple pentad prisms here and an undercity informer. Well, I'll take the... Taking the pentad's kind of weird here. If they hit a second land, we're in trouble because they'll be able to do the spy unless it's a green. And I can't take the pentad to slow that down. So I guess I'll take the undercity informer and kind of hope they miss a land here for one or two turns. It's going to be unlikely, but could happen. All right. Let's go ahead and thin the library ever so slightly here. And then let's opt, put this on top, and slap down a Nile Spellbomb. What a perfect few things to happen here. What a few things that happened there that were so nice. Oh, look. Oh, all right. We played some things. We might have goofed up in game one, but we played smart in game two, and then my opponent mulliganed to oblivion. Game three has been a mulligan to, or the last game of both matches has been a mulligan to infinity for our opponents. Whitelisted? Whitelisted? I need a new set of headphones. I need a new set of headphones that I can wear wirelessly, being attached. You see this little clip? I clipped this to me so that I don't accidentally have this fall off my head. Clips here so I can get up, move around a little bit. Super stretchy. Super stretchy cord. It goes for forever, but it's like being attached. All right, enough about our headphones. I think Uncle DB said they knew some people for some headphones that would be good in the summer. Won't be so hot. Anywho. All that being said, we found our opponent. Let's go. All right. Jace's ultimate. Well, we've done that. We understand you, opponent. We get to play first, too. I like that. We have a Luris deck with two Inquisitions here and a pair of Spreading Seas. I'm not on the draw. I don't think I can keep this. I think I need a little bit more help than just Inquisitioning my Luris friend. You bought Bluetooth headphones? Yeah, they're convenient, but yeah, I can't stand the sound sometimes. We can't. If this was a watery grave, maybe I keep this. The fact that it's a swamp just bothers me a whole bunch here. I think we can do better. Let's mulligan. What's better than not having a swamp? Field of the Ruin. All right. Here we go. All right, we can do this. We can get rid of grave and consume, probably. We'll shuffle those back in momentarily. A little creeping tar pit. See what my opponent's up to. Maybe Spreading Seas their first land here. Maybe they'll get stuck on mana. Watch it be mono blue Luris. All right, Blood Crypt to lead off with. We're going to Inquisition Thoughtseize. There we go. Probably wants to take Drown the Lock. If they take the Spreading Seas, it makes me think they only have the one. All right, we draw a swamp of our own and pass the turn. Now this Drown the Lock should be able to kill anything they play. They have two cards already in the yard. My opponent shocks in a Blood Crypt here. Do I allow this to resolve? That's two damage to them and they're taking my Drown the Lock anyway. The only thing that cracking here does is it does turn on Scourges. I'm actually going to go ahead and counter this. That also makes sure they don't see that the swamp is here. Look, it's Bowmat. It's Bowmat. In for a point. Liliana off the top. All right. They don't know about Cryptic. They don't know about Swamp right now. We'll just pass the turn. No actions. Polluted Delta. Blood Crypts here. Swift Spears. Swift Spears. Wow. 3 damage. Down to 15 we go. All right. Play our Swamp here. We'll pass the turn. I guess I just let this resolve here. Yeah, I think I let this resolve because I'm probably just tapping team and drawing a card. We're looking for Damnation. So we'll just tap and draw. Maybe hope they don't have another Inquisition Thoughtseize. All right, cling to dust. Okay, we can leave ourselves a mana leak up here. We can use cling to dust to draw or gain life. Nope, no gain life. That's silly. If they sacrifice Bowmat, it would be gaining some life. Opponent attacks for 3, drains another card off Bowmat here. We go to 12. Attempts to team or battle rage. I suppose I want to stop this. That is a reasonable amount of damage. We'll just make it 5, putting me to 10 here. I'll probably use the cling to dust to draw a card. Like I said, we're trying to find probably Damnation at this point. Land, then consume the Meek would also work. Well, there's a land. It's not a good land. It's my one of Dark Slick Shores in the list. We could defend with Creeping Tar Pit as well, which may be what we're doing. All right. Go ahead. I really don't like that Bowmat's gonna have 4 cards under it when it attacks again. Shame. Wonder if I'm supposed to boot up the Creeping Tar Pit to defend this time. I suppose if I don't defend, they can just wait for forever to use Bowmat and just keep hitting me down, which is probably what they want to do against a control matchup. So we'll send this back. We'll probably boot Creeping Tar Pit up, trying to block Bowmat. Hope they don't have like Bolt. How is the control player? Do I have more time than my opponent? So confusing. All right, your turn, opponent. What do you got? Another land. Attacks with everything. Boots up. Let's go ahead and see if we can get Creeping Tar Pit. They'll sacrifice Bowmat here, seeing if they can remove the Tar Pit. Bolts Tar Pit. Okay, 4 damage in, it puts us to 6. Marsh Flats, maybe play a Scourge or a Death Shadow. Knight's Whisper, ooh, nice. Nifty, and a Bobble. Okay, plenty of things. Draws cards too. Consume the Meek would be super nice. Inquisition, it's not very good. All right, what do we got? Another Bowmat, Bobble, and Scourge. Well, I'm going to take Bowmat because it draws them cards. They can hit me for four here. I might have to Cling to Dust for a bit of life here. There's a Croxa. I think I want to get rid of this Croxa before this happens. A little surprised they didn't just go for the Croxa there since I gave them the opportunity to. They decided to crack a Bloodstained Mire instead of using their mana. So we know it's Scourge and something else. That's a lot of mana. What are you doing? Seal of Fire. This makes these 6 damage, 7, 8. I'm going to go to 1. Okay. Plays the Scourge out. Good for us to see. At the same time, they can play Luris pretty easily. So Bobble trigger. Grave Titan. We are a land short. All right. Damnation, Galidus, Liliana. All seem all right. Aether Gust and Frost Titan. What do we not like? Cling to Dust is probably interesting enough because we saw Croxa. Spreading Sea is definitely okay. Jace feeling iffy. Gearhulk's not very good here. Mystical Teachings is fine because it gets Consume and Cryptics. Fatal Pushes Drown the Locks. I suppose Liliana doesn't really hit too many things. That's 3 out. Could be the first 3 things. Mana Leak feels like it's going to get most things. I'm wondering if I should just take the Cling to Dust out for the 2 Aether Gust and then find one more room for Frost Titan. Because they have Croxa, they've got Luris. It's like a reason to go after their graveyard a little bit. I don't think that matters as much. I think being able to just consume Damnation and counter one or two things, it won't matter what they have out. We should be able to handle it. So I'm going to take the Clings out. I want this Frost Titan. You don't like Gust? You don't like that Teemer Battle Rage? Seal of Fires? All of that? You don't want to worry about Blood Moon? What could I take out for Frost Titan here? Maybe it's just Jace. I mean, Jace, I guess, can bounce something. It's an okay tempo play. I'll take 1 Spreading Seas out. I'll go 2 Spreading Seas. What if I just brought the Nile Spell Bombs in then and not worry about that? You know what? All right. We're going to do 2 Nile Spell Bombs here over the Spreading Seas. Spreading Seas would help us against Blood Moon, but I think for some reason I'll be okay. You know, let's not worry about it too much. Opening hand's completely fine here. We'll definitely go fetch a basic with the first Polluted Delta, basic island, and then maybe a Bloodstained Mire. Hand looks pretty good though. Take a check at what's going on there. Got the Liliana. And top end Grave Titan. Grave Titan's probably going to go bye-bye. You know, but we can't always ask for Grave Titan to be in the library instead. I don't think the Lily destroys necessarily. Alright, Inquisition here. What do we got? Angrass, Bolt, Swift Spear. I think I just want to take Swift Spear here, honestly. Teamer Battle Rage, we can just remember to play around that. And I don't think I want to do Angrass because I'm going to have to downtick on Swift Spear and they just bolt me. So let's take the Swift Spear. I also don't have that much interaction initially, so it seems like an okay start here. Let's stay Mire for my opponent. Hands the turn back. We pick up a Drown the Lock. That's pretty good. Sunbaked Canyon's played here. We're fetching. Blood Crypt. Knight's Whisper. This is actually kind of worth a... It's kind of worth a counter. Them drawing cards is kind of annoying. Let's keep that in check. I wonder if I can wait on Liliana or if I should just slam it. Let's wait. We got the mana leak. Let's wait. Angrass Rampage is an interesting choice for a card. Yeah, we've been playing it a little bit in our Rakdos midrange lists. Bomad, huh? Get out of here. I don't want any creatures. Uninterested in your Bomad. Try again tomorrow. Try again tomorrow. Watery Grave here, just so I have the double black when I want to play Liliana. Mystic Sanctuary makes it a little awkward here. I could Snapcaster and Inquisition. You know what? Let's get aggressive. Let's get aggressive. Snapcaster, Inquisition clears the way Liliana comes down. And then unless it's a land... I'll plan to uptick. Look at this. They just bolt too. Just bolts. Inquisition here. Check what that lasts in. Death Shadow or Angrath? I'll take Angrath here and give them the Death Shadow. They can't even cast it. They can't even cast it. Tastes like metal? Yeah, Rampage has a game against Boggles, which is pretty sweet. Not to mention that many players are just playing a singleton artifact or singleton planeswalker. Wow, they draw with that. Nice. Oh, no, opponent. I think I'm just going to pass turn with a Snapcaster. Snap Mana Leak, Snap Drown the Lock seems just so much better than this Liliana right now. And I don't really want to uptick here and lose my Grave Titan, so... Let's just hang out with our opponent here, just casually playing some things down, getting ready to counter, getting ready to slam the 2010 Titan. Titan that deserves more respect. Bobble. That's fine, you can draw a card. I don't care. I don't care about that. Try again. Come back tomorrow. Give me a land. Give me the land. Not bad either. Cool. All right. Continue on we go. Sunbaked Canyon's been found here. There is a Kroxa. You may put the Kroxa back on top of your library if you like. Isn't that cute? Isn't that cute? All right, land me. That's a fatal push. Whatever. Whatever. I'm gonna make this another Aether Gust instead of the mana leaks or other things like that. I'm basically just trying to tempo my opponent out. This turn they'll also play that Death Shadow for me and I'll get to Fatal Push it. Land. Thank you. This game's over. Am I sponsored by Hydro Flask? No. Say hello to Grave Titan. Say hello to Grave Titan. I probably should just get rid of that link. Knight's Whisper is my opponent's choice. Going down to 6 here after taking some damage. They have Crocs in hand. What else are they going to do? It's just a Grave Titan. Ooh. The answer is no, they can't beat a Grave Titan. All right, you can see there where a Spreading Seas would make sense because my opponent's going to have like 2 or 3 mana. Could really mess them up. By the way, Aether Gust did well, tempoing our opponent out a few turns in a row. The only reason I want to keep Liliana the Veil in here is because Liliana the Veil is just like an edict effect. If we can keep them kind of a bit off balance like we did there, it can be pretty sweet. We may not change anything. I don't think we need to. Be hilarious to Torrential Gearhulk and the Consume the Meek. Consume the Meek kills everything they play. I wonder if Gearhulk's better than like a Jace, honestly. Squatchy, welcome. How are the Squatchies? Sasquatches. Like, there's definitely value for the Frost Titan, but there's also some, like, weird value for Torrential Gearhulk on, like, Drown, Fatal Push, and Cryptics. I know it's at 6 mana. It could come in for 1 Nile Spell Bomb. You know what? Let's chance it. Let's chance it. Something tells me I'm going to get the Mystical Teachings and consume this poor person. That's what's going to happen. All right, this hand looks completely fine. It's just, I'm gonna have to deal with the first turn, the second turn, but after that, there'll be history. We'll lead with Flooded Strand here, getting Basic Island, just to make sure we're all on the up and up. Squatch support, I see that there, Harry. See that. All right, I'll keep. Go ahead, smack us with Bowmat or something. Hey, Bowmat. The little artifact that could. All right, more than likely Basic Island here. All right, they can sneak one more thing down. That's good. You can take my mana leak, that's fine. That's fine. We have plenty of lands. Now I just gotta hit spells. Gotta hit them spells. Wow. Opponent's on the one land thing here going on. I think I'm okay to still fetch a basic. Okay, Frost Titan's a little ways away. I think I'm gonna play this island and pass turn. We don't have anything that I care about to be playing on a double black except Liliana, and I'm just not gonna find that. Thoughtseize, huh? I like my Frost Titan. Opponent's not taking my Frost Titan. They're just hooking themselves up with bone mats. Don't worry, we got this, everyone. We got this, watch. All right, Marsh Flats for our opponent. We can see another creature here. Hopefully it's red. That would be the hope. Bowmat coming in for some more here. They do have red now that they can use Bowmat's ability. They may just keep it checked here with the Blood Crypt. We'll see. Scourge. All right, couldn't do anything about Scourge. Damnation. Consume, we're so close. Okay. 5-6. I just got to take a whopping 1,000 damage here. No team or battle rage, please. I guess I can Aether guess that. All right. Checks themselves. Got to know what's coming up. I need them to tap that blood crypt for me. Death Shadow's fine. It's just a silly 1/1. Unfortunately, I do have to get like a Watery Grave here with the Polluted Delta. Something I must do. Okay. Bobble draws. We have a drown in the lock. All right. So, before, at beginning of combats, when I'm going to fire off the consume the meek. Yeah, we're going to consume in beginning of combat here. Hoping my opponent slams another creature here, like a Swift Spear, going for the kill. Yes. Yes, bring them all in. One more. Yes, that's sort of okay. More creatures. Play one more. One more. Consume. Consumed. All right. Got rid of a Seal Fire. That's okay. All right. I can play a Frost Titan down if I want to. As a Mystical Teachings. So I gotta tap down a Blood Crypt here. That seems like the right play here. Let's do this to see if I can grab Consume the Meek back. Can I have that card, please, Soul Guide Lantern? Will you allow me to draw that card? I'll actually take this if they allow it. May I? This card. This consume. Will you offer it to me? Uninterested. All right, fine. Fine, then I'll just tighten you. Keep the Blood Crypt tapped down. Good luck, opponent. Opponent's at 8. We have Aether Gust, Drown the Lock, and a Mystical Teachings. Mystical Teachings can go get another Drown the Lock. If I get to untap, we'll have plenty of things to counter with. Polluted Delta for our opponent. They can fetch for a basic, but I hope they don't do anything else with Shocklands, because that would be bad. Thought Seizes me. That puts them to 5, which makes this lethal. This makes this lethal. Mystical Teachings guarantees I can find Fatal Push or Drown the Lock. Drown the Lock would kill anything. Aether Gust can bounce red spells. Takes my Mystical Teachings. 2 mana Scourge. GG's. Right? Did I miss something? Here. We'll do it off Jace. Give Jace the W. Bounce. Swing. We could just attack with Frost Titan. Remember, this has text. Does stuff when you attack, too. All right. We're doing a decent with blue-black. Blue-black Grave Titan. Decent. It's doing all right. Getting the stuff done. It's so swift. It's an interesting little pile. It does some fun things. All right, I get to go first. We have Ivan. We have a hand that I'm pretty happy with this. Lead with Inquisition, we got the Mana Leak. If we see nothing to worry here, we can get that Creeping Tar Pit down pretty quick. Got some basics, got the Field of Ruin. In case it's Tron, we got all kinds of stuff covered. Dryad Engineered Explosives, sure. Marauder Otter. You know what I had for lunch? It was delicious. Do I just, like, I feel like I just take the Dryad here. It's like, what are they gonna do with this engineered explosives? I mean, they're gonna put it on six? All right, Titan. Gotta beat Titan now. That's something we could do. Something we could do. All right, what are we doing, Ivan? Castle. Decides not to put Triome in. That's fine. Cool. We'll just do it this way. Work our way up the chain here. Island. I've got Mana Leak open. I don't fire off the Inquisition just yet. I could Field of Ruin this at some point. EE for nothing. They can do whatever they want. Flooded Grove here. Okay, Creeping Tar Pit down. I think we'll just pass the turn again here. Leaving myself Mana Leak or Opt open. Kind of just hanging out with our opponent. Not doing anything too crazy. Bottom the Opt since I don't have another island. There we go, Polluted Delta, seems good. Whew. Not gonna quite do this Jace here. So, if I'm not gonna do Jace, I think I can go ahead and Inquisition again, see what else my opponent's picked up in the meantime. Which happens to be more lands. Because it's more lands, I'm kinda tempted to just knock this one off. So we'll put Field of Ruin out for that option. There's literally nothing else for me to take. I wonder if I get super greedy and get this Jace down. Cycles Triome. Nice. I could also just put the Jace down for one. Or by itself, I guess. Let's go ahead and get a little more blue for us. Fatal Push. I would so like to kicker this. It's the whole point of having it, but keeping myself with a Mana Leak open is probably the smarter line here, right? We don't know two of the cards. Let's just... let's fetch first. I know this makes Fatal Push a little bit weaker in the future. Man, I just want to go twice here. I'm not going to get punished. Kick it. Kick it. I want to kick it. You all know you want to kick it. There's no way they have a counter here. I'm going to be sick to my stomach if they have a counter. That's right. Double Jace. So I scry with this one then. First, and then I can see if I want to pick up the cards. So scry two. We can kind of like a Spreading Seas. All right, we're going to do a no on the Spreading Seas. We're going to put the Drown the Lock to the top. And I'm just going to draw the Drown the Lock. Cool. Now they know about it, but that's okay. Here's their chance. What do you got for us? We have ways to kill Dryads, so this is why I'm not super concerned here. Because I can make these disappear too, possibly, to create Revolt. Ah, Dryad. Waterlogged and... cracks the Waterlogged. Okay. Misty. Okay. Go ahead and scry. I like both of these cards. Let's put the consume on the bottom because I can then use this Jace to pick up this Jace, which allows me to Fatal Push this and leave Drown and Mana Leak and then have this Jace in hand. Which I sort of like that line. Yeah, we're gonna do this. I think we've got some good time here with my opponent. This Jace has been amazing so far. It's a gross spiral. Probably, you know what? They know about the Drown the Lock. You know what, let's get aggressive here. I've got the Snapcaster, I've got the Mana Leak. Extra land here, we know about a forest here. Nice. Oh, nice. Okay. Scry here. Bottom. Don't need more lands. 1, 2, 3, 4. Jace. Not going to Fate Seal due to 2 Misty Rainforest here. We're just going to pick up a new card here. Cool. That all looks fantastic. Mystical Mana Leak, play Mystic Sanctuary, put Drown the Lock back on top for funsies in the future. Fate Seal ourselves, continue to scry. I'm just trying to avoid a Primeval Titan this one turn. My opponent puts a Growth Spiral potentially back on top, and they do. Okay. So Growth Spiral, can't really do much. I've got a Mana Leak. Hopefully they get to play 2 lands here and... Ooh, okay, they just done. This Jace. Okay. So, Ashiok comes in for this matchup. Aether Gust is green too, right? Red or green. Frost Titan's kind of interesting. Damnation's kind of interesting. Let's see if we want these cards. What do we not like? Liliana Last Hope's probably a no-go in this matchup. This Jace just proved to be a very good asset here. Why don't we play this more? Probably get rid of a few Clings. That seems okay to do. Probably need to keep these Fatal Pushes. Drown's fine. Spreading Seas is a way to answer field, so I'll probably... leave those in. Let's see here. Can I find one more? Consumes are right. I think I'm okay with a consume. They do appear to be a non-Elvish... The Elvish Reclaimer? So probably don't want to worry about that. Mana Leaks get worse as we go in the game. Torrential Gearhulk is hitting what? Cryptic and Drowns? Maybe I take a Gearhulk out here and just go, hey, because I'm on the draw, I've got to be a little bit lower here. Aethergust Ashiok and see if we can't get them to stop searching for things. And then I've got these Damnations. Maybe I bring the Damnation back in and put a Frost Titan as well. And get rid of like Consume the Meek. For a Damnation, and then like find a spot for this Frost Titan, which may be just a one of like Spreading Seas. The idea is if they do land a Titan, I can Titan them back and keep their Titan from attacking us. It's not a great line, but it is a line. I think we're good to try that. Got a few weird things we've got going on, but such is those mystical teachings. Mario, thank you for the follow, by the way. Thank you. All right, I like the hand. I'm gonna go ahead and keep it. Do need to hit a few lands, but I do like a Drown, Mana Leak, and then the ability to Snapcaster them back if we hit those lands. Damnation's the fail safe in case my opponent gets ahead of us. My opponent's mulliganed to 5 cards. Once again, opponents are mulliganing a whole bunch on their final matches. Final games against us in each match. I'll take it. I say final. We've only played one. Do I see the future? 5 cards. Valakut into play. Alright, go ahead. I did not look at the spice, because it's not a deck redeem. Bunny's gotta follow the rules here. Alright. Well, we got Drown the Lock and Mana Leak. Drown's not doing a whole lot, although it'll get slightly better with that Misty. My opponent appears to have missed. Super bad for them. Gonna work our way up to this Jace. Land for my opponent. Okay. I can't immediately slam Jace here. Cool. And now we'll look at that at the end of the league. I'm gonna play the Darslick Shores down. It's my one of. I want to change this to a... There's a... The Flooded Grove version of blue-black. I don't remember what it is. That's what I want here. Spreading Seas, please. Spreading Seas wouldn't do a whole lot here. Misty Rainforest number 2. Opponents just working their way up here. I need another land. Extra Drown the Lock seems good here. Drown the Locks are going to slowly get better. Once I get one more land, I can play Jace and have like Drown or Mana Leak open. We need to counter the Dryad. Maybe. There's a Field of the Dead, not looking great for us. Aether Gust. I could, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could brainstorm with Jace, hoping to hit a land here. If I miss this land, we're in trouble. At the same time, maybe we're not. You know what? Jace away. I'm gonna hit that land. We got this. What? 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 Why are they playing Remand? This isn't good. This isn't good. Extra Field. I don't want to get rid of any of this. I'm gonna get rid of the Mana Leak. It's getting worse as we go. Four mana, six, two, four, five. This would make it six. Could be a Titan here. Got the Damnation for that at least. Plays a island. Choosing to leave up a Triumph. Nope, Hour of Promise. All right, well, Hour of Promise wasn't what I was aiming for. This will give them some zombies. Not entirely worried about this. Vesuva to copy a Field of the Dead here. And they make lots of zombies. It's a couple zombies. All right, so we hit a Field of Ruin for us. If I think they have another Remand, I need to leave a Drown the Lock open. Which I think they might have. I need to probably deal with these fields later. Let's go ahead and Damnation here, leaving Drown and Aether Gust open in case they have that Remand. Appears they don't. Sweet. All right, so we can pretty much counter everything but a Titan right now. If they play a Dryad, I can kill that. Here's an Uro. go ahead and Aether Gust this, trying to tempo them out a little bit this turn. They can bounce Palace in the Cloud, so they can get at least, what is it, three or so here. Looks like my opponent's got a counter of some sorts again. They have Cryptic Command? Wow, Cryptic Command, all right. Well, my opponent's gonna make six zombies here. At least I can Snapcaster Damnation again. Little awkward that this won't be in play. In response to this, they could pick this up. Make sure they hit their land drop. They don't hit their land drop. Okay, so I've got a couple Snapcasters here. We have a Chalice on one, not worried about that. We have a Spreading Seas. So I can get rid of two fields. This might be the turn to go ahead and get rid of two fields and just hang tight for a turn. So one to use this, one to Spreading Seas and leave up a Drown the Lock. That'll slow down the zombie creation here. I've done this slightly backwards. I should have Spreading Seas first. Now they have a lot more zombies than I planned. Counters their own Veil. 10 damage here? I think I can handle 10. I think I can handle 10. We'll see. All right. Ouch. Huh. Nothing to follow this up with. All right. Snap. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to just shock this in here so I can snap. I can counter and also play the Damnation. Little supplies they haven't used the Euro, but I don't know if they know about my Drown the Locks just yet. A little surprised they didn't do balancing with the Palace as well. All right, Damnation away. Hey, thank you for the follow. Looks like my opponent's going to attempt to counter. We will counter back. We have to. They have another counter on top of this one. Man, they had another Cryptic. All right. They can get around our Snapcaster. So, that was a thing. Feeling like I need a Duress or two now. Probably this Negate. Bring back the Spreading Seas here. Not worry about Frost Titan. Bring Torrential in for some of the counter wars we're running into. Sometimes you need a good lore audio MTG book. Let's drop one Jace here. I don't know if it's a thing or not. One Fatal Push can be dropped here. Maybe I just get rid of all the Fatal Pushes. Keep myself a Jace here since I'm on the play. We have two Ashioks to deal with. The Uros. All right, I'm gonna submit. A lot more counters than I thought it was. I thought it was just a normal Titan. This hand's not getting there. Need more lands than a Sanctuary. This one could do it. This one could do it. I almost am tempted to put the Field of Ruin back. But I could mess up their mana a little bit. Just keep get rid of a Damnation. I've got a few of those. Watery Grave tapped and past turn. We do know that they have Veil as well. It's something we have to worry about. Land Shredder, what's up? How you doing? I don't know if the lore audiobook is a thing. Rex RDX. I don't know. They have books on tape, right? Or books on digital audio now? Maybe it's a thing. Maybe it's a thing. All right, what do we need? What do we need? A little more interaction would be good here. One thing in the yard so far, helping our drown the locks and mana leaks. Looks like my opponent's gonna do nothing there. Start with an Inquisition without playing our land to see if I want to shock this in or if I can play the island just for the mana leak. This is a Veil, it looks like. Which is kind of fine. I don't foresee myself using the mana or the mana leak in response to a Veil. All right, so we have ourselves a mana leak available to us. Soul Guide's fine. I'm just double checking that it can't interact with my opponent's graveyard, making my drown a little bit weaker. All right, a little Field of Ruin here. Perhaps if they do something with the Scalding Tarn, I'm just going to go ahead and field away. Maybe the Triome here. Okay. Little Soul Guide Lantern here. Fetching. Let's go ahead and nail the Triome here as well. Go get more islands. We have the Watery Grave. We're looking pretty good. We'll use fields to try to make the mana a little bit awkward for them. They can obviously find another Triome with the Scalding Tarn. We'll end up fielding that. We could be saving these fields for Field of the Dead. I think making their mana awkward enough and then being able to mana leak and drown the lock, though, may just be smarter. Maybe it's not. Maybe I should be saving the fields. But we also have Spreading Seas. It's a Valakut that I'm not worried about. Start with an Opt. Well, that can make mana weird. Let's nail the Triome. Is it snowing where I live? No. Are we gonna counter this Triome? This Triome's giving him... They beast within their own Triome. I can't be afraid of a 3-3, right? This is like fine for me because it actually like is a stone rain now for my Spreading Seas. They do damage, become creatures, make creatures, draw cards. They are. They're all over the place, right? See if we can hit the Flooded Grove here. I'm almost hoping they go get like blue, but if they go get something else, I can attempt a Spreading Seas. I'm gonna tap and use some green mana here. Green and blue, there's a Growth Spiral. Leaving one green up, it's probably Veil, so I probably have to just let Growth Spiral go. This is fine because we can Spreading Seas the land that they play in here. It's a Waterlogged Grove. Still doing things here. Are we gonna Beast Within again? They Beast Within again. This Stone Rain's me now. Stone Rain's them again. It's a boom bust. I think I let that go. And go Spreading Seas now. Just take them off of some of the stuff that they can do. This tapped in and passed turn. Okay. They have kind of a free turn here, but they have no green. Another Valakut. So no green, we got some blue. We got Blue Moon across from us. Hits for six though. 2, 3, 4, got Snap, we have Drowns. I think I'm just gonna pass back here and maybe just drown one of these tokens, see if I can find a way to protect Jace before trying to play Jace. Palace. I'm going to attack with a few beasties here. We're going to go ahead and drown one of them. If they go to defend this with like a cryptic command, I'll probably attempt to counter it. We're going to remand. We're doing this in attack step, so I could theoretically play a Snapcaster down. Cool. Lant. Little Jace. Let's play Little Jace. They're like, whoa, 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 what are we doing here? Little Jace? Don't worry about Little Jace. Remands Little Jace. All right. I think I've got to take this. Hoping to draw a land, we do. Let's go ahead and fetch here. I think I can get a little more on the swamp stuff here, but I could also pick up that Drown the Lock in the yard for the future. Let's not worry about it. Jace here, if Jace resolves, I bounce the token. Testing if they have another Remand or a Cryptic here. They have a mana leak. Can't pay for that. Am I going to one? I should have used Mana Leak on the Veil. I mean, I didn't know I was going to draw a whole bunch of Spreading Seas. We're going to go to one. All right, well, last hurrah here. Snapcaster to block and or drown the lock. Making sure we have our stop on our attack step here. Snapcaster. Not worried about that 3-3. Mana Leak. So even if they remand something here, I can Snapcaster back down to defend. What does that buy me? A turn. Zale, those are famous last words, right? Oh my gosh. They have another remand. I've kept them off all their green. Mana leak targeting. Targeting my mana leak. Well, I guess I pay for that. Which then counters their cryptic, making them not draw. And then Snapcaster just a block here. I wanted it to be a Drown the Lock, but, you know. All right, what do we draw here? An Ashiok. So Ashiok doesn't get it, so I have to Jace and I have to down tick and hope I hit something. Down tick, come on, interactive spell. Opt gives me more looks. Opting, creeping tar pit's not, down. Polluted Delta. Not enough. All right, so the beast killed me. How was I supposed to know that I was gonna get beaten by beasts? You know what? Not. I win. I went out on my own terms. Next draw, Dark Slick. We're gonna draw again and hit a Grave Titan, which would have been enough. I needed one more turn, it looks like. Then I was gonna hit the things I needed. All good. Blue black Grave Titan here, currently 3-1. I thought the beast idea can hit. The beast idea can hit. Three beats, I guess is what we're saying. Yeah. A little surprising. I thought I could handle a 3-3. Having the drowns, having Jace, Cryptics, Damnations, Consumes, and then blockers. I figured I would find one eventually. Yeah. Can't believe that. That's what beat us. That is what beat us. All right, we got one more match here, and then we'll look at Bunny's list, and then we'll see what we're doing for league number two. We got two options here, and we'll be polling you all for that in a bit. In a bit. Fifth and final match. Doing pretty well with the Titan. Doing pretty well. I think I'd have to play against that other Titan list a few more times to really know when I'm supposed to be using drowns, when I'm supposed to be using spreading seas, and so on and so forth. Lurrus deck here. I think we can keep this. Got some nice interaction with Fatal Push. Clean to Dust isn't a bad card against Lurrus. Watch my opponent Thought Seize my hand apart here. Here we go. Blood Crypt. Inquisitions. It's pretty good. All right, Drown the Lock's pretty much online now because of the Lurrus. Cling to Dust is pretty cool because it can draw me cards. I imagine Fatal Push gets taken here. We'll see. We will see. Takes my Drown. Bobble here as well. Uses Bobble. And pick up a Damnation. They're aware of this, I believe. Yes. So they know my entire hand right now. Wooded Foothills. Probably gonna use this Cling to Dust to draw a card. Not so worried about the Lurrus. It's Cling to Dust, their Bobble. It's kind of a weird card. It's something I'm just not quite used to yet. It's a Kroxa. I'll just cling that then instead. I'll just get rid of the Damnation. I think this is a super easy target to go ahead and just cling and not worry about it. Gear Hulk. They don't know about that card. It's a little ways off. A little ways off. Tarmogoyf. I'm just going to pass here. Not a whole lot on three that I care to be playing. We need another island. Although this land allows me to cling. Opponent attacking, I'll happily kill their Tarmogoyf. Looks like they just had nothing else to do, apparently. Well, Polluted Delta is pretty nice. Now I can use Cling from the Yard or I can Cryptic Command. We're getting there. We're getting there. Pretty easy basic island to go fetch here. I've already got plenty of black. Stomping Ground shouldn't really enable anything new. Death Shadow. I think this is worth a counter. Nice. Creeping Tar Pit in, pass turn. We got Drown the Lock to defend ourselves again. I'm surprised the shock, but I guess it's just to get Death Shadow down. Surprised they didn't maybe have another follow-up. Scourges are looking really silly right now because of us gaining some life with the Cling to Dust. At end step, I might even just work to gain some more with the Tarmogoyfs and the Death Shadows being taken by the Cling here. I could also just wait because of Gearhulk for Cryptic Command. So we'll do that. Pass turn, let's play at instant speed. How's Gearhulk looking? Lurrus is currently in hand. Shall we get the Gearhulk down, everyone? Ren and six, huh? I doubt that Gearhulk gets killed here. Doing this to play on Cryptic Command and counter draw here just seems like kind of like a just do this. Nice. Let them have the Ren and six. I think I'm good. No Ren and sixes for them. We can't do that, Avaros. Not allowed. Couple ops here. Let's go ahead and opt once before combat. Bottom this. Spreading Seas. Go ahead and attack for five here. I'll leave myself Drown the Lock open here. I guess because I did that. Let's Spreading Seas away one of the black sources, and now they can't even play Lurrus here. Draws me another card. Maybe I hit the land. Ooh, didn't have the fourth island. My bad. Third island. All right, my opponent does find their basic swamp here. Nice. Lurrus, super easy counter here. Super easy counter. And end step opt. Put Snapcaster on top. Attack with Gearhulk. Easy mode from here. Sitting at a pretty 22. Being the blue and the black player. Lands nice here too. Attack, go, go, go. Phone's at seven. Pete lands. I can Mystical Teachings for a Cryptic Command if I wanted to. My opponent does nothing. I'm just going to sit here and do nothing as well. I kill them in two shots anyway. Yes, I could boot up the Creeping Tar Pit. No, I don't want to do that. There's very little that could go wrong here by waiting. Mystical Teachings for the win. Dismembers. Dismember doesn't even kill this. Sure. Lightning Bolt. All right. I'll Snapcaster now, and I'm going to counter this. They saved one life. Now I'm presenting uber lethal. Uber lethal. Cycles of Pete land. Just Pete land. Plays a land. Wooded Foothills. Bolts, Snapcaster. In response to the bolt, I'm going to go ahead and opt just to see if I do pick up a counter. I do not. Looks like my opponent can go to one now. Sometimes it's good to just play the long game. Sometimes it's good just to play the long game. Go ahead, opponent. Good luck. Yes, I could have Creeping Tar Pit, but sometimes you just want to show them the Titan. Show them what spice you're playing, what they're up against. scare them could all be worth it in the end. All right, consume the meek looking good again. Torrential and Grave Titan, okay. Liliana and Frost Titan come in for this matchup. And take a couple clings out. We're just gonna slam it. I'm not gonna worry about this extra damnation. I'm not gonna worry about this Galitas. We're gonna try to do this with a little less sideboarded to see if we're overkilling this matchup or if we can possibly free up some space in the sideboard. Looking pretty good. Deck is the blue-black Grave Titan one. There's a few lists there, and I put the few lists there so people have a few decks that we are either playing tonight or have previously played. Always nice to share with our peoples. All right, opponent. Match five here, currently 3-1. Up a game against Lurrus Jund, Death Shadow. I like this list. There's a calmness about this list. You're just like, ah, Grave Titan. It's been so long here. All right, opening hand I don't particularly like too much. A little bit softer. I'll slam keep it though. Why not? Go ahead and take my opt opponent. Ooh, all right, Swiss Spear. In for point. Frosty Boy is here. All right, we'll F6 through a few turns here. Not getting a whole lot going on. We'll just make our way up to that damnation. Don't worry about it. Overgrown Tomb here, Blood Crypt. Could see a Tarmogoyf. Could see a Scourge. Shoxin. Extra Swift Spear here. Attacks for the points. Two of them, to be exact. And moves on. Top of the library for us is a Flooded Strand. We'll go ahead and take that card. All right, this leaves us with Drown the Lock as an option here. We can also opt if my opponent doesn't do something totally crazy to us. Got to work our way up to Frost Titan. We'll allow them to attack us for two. Not so worried about that. Down to 15. 15. Fetching. That's really good for us because now we can hit something at two, like a Tarmogoyf. Stomping Ground. Shocked in. So now we have what? Death Shadow? I will happily get rid of this. Question is, do I get Watery Grave or Island? I think I gotta preserve the life total a bit and get an Island, making things a little bit weaker to Damnation off the top. We are up a game. We are up a game. Thanks for asking. Okay, Watery Grave sideways so that I'm preserving my life total. I've got this opt. We'll see if my opponent just hits me for three. If that's the case, I think I just let it all happen. Make it look like we still have a counter up. We're basically going to try to dig for this damnation. All right, damnation, where are you at? That is not a damnation. I think I have to bottom. Liliana doesn't save us. Mana Leak is not one either. Damnation? Right here? Mystical Teachings. Hey, Jace. What's up? So I'm currently going to get hit for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 damage. I can snap and drown. Snap, block, drown, Tarmogoyf, take 3. I guess that's what I'm going to do here. I'm hoping no fetch land. Oh, crap. Alright, well, Snapcaster into drown, it looks like. And now I have to drown the Death Shadow, it looks like. I took your trophy? Oh no. I'm sorry. All right, we're gonna force the Verdant Catacombs here. We really, really need... Uh-oh. Fetches and shocks. They haven't done anything all game. Teamer Battle Rages on their own Death Shadow here. Double Strike and Trample kills us. All right, I immediately regret not bringing in the Damnation. We talked about, hey, can we do it? The answer is no. I do want these Aether Gusts once again as well. So the last time we had this, I did this. We can do Gear Hulk out, Lily Last Hopes out, and one Spreading Seas. And now that I'm on the play, I think I got rid of Jace. Even though Jace was impressive, we're gonna do this and bring in some of the ways we interacted the first time we ran into this version of the deck. All right, let's play first. I took it fairly. All right. This hand could get there. Let's keep and steal something and then be a little slow to our next card. But we're on the play. Should be enough time. We'll see. Couple bolts, a bobble, and a scourge. Well, I guess I'll take the scourge. I don't care about the random redraw. Take the scourge. We've got the drown the lock. We got a time for the opt. Burning Catacombs, bobble, and they drew a bobble. So we know perfect information for the moment until they double draw here. Yep. Where are the fatal pushes? They're in there somewhere. We'll find them. We can Inquisition again if I wanted to. Or do I opt? Let me go ahead and opt here. Frost Item Bottom. Ah, nice. Go ahead and Inquisition. They did only draw one thing, but it is Tarmogoyf. Happy to take that. Was going to be happy to take Lightning Bolts as well. Everything's coming together here. Verdant Catacombs. We'll pay attention to when this Lurrus disappears from their companion. Bobble, second trigger, double draw here, going back up to 6. Pete Land's played. Thoughtseize, so they'll take either Snapcaster or Drown the Lock. Probably snap. Oh, nope. All right, they just take the drown. Speaking of fatal pushes. Speaking of fatal pushes. If they put Lurrus in the hand, it's an easy snap Inquisition. We'll see if that's what they want to do. Seal of Fire. Bolt and something else. Get rid of Scourge here. Watery Grave looks pretty nice. We'll go ahead and shock this in because now I have Snapcaster, Drown, or Cryptic Command. I'm going to try to take this home. We're getting there. I know Frost Titan is somewhere on the bottom, right? Peatland or Burning Catacombs for our opponent. Puts Lurrus into hand. So, do we snap Inquisition for that? Why do that? Why do that when you can just draw Inquisition off the top? Take the Laris. I'm just gonna pass the turn. I'll probably snap Caster Opt at this point. Two bolts. We could also snap Caster Fatal Push a creature here if they play that. All right, so Verdant Catacombs. I think we'll just wait. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Now we're looking good. Got lots of options here. Easy snap drown the lock, whatever their first thing is here. I guess I'll just snap and fatal push it instead. Kind of keep our drown the lock down there for a future use. I presume Seal or Lightning Bolts will hit the Snapcaster. Probably this Seal of Fire. But if not, I'll get a chance to attack. A little surprised they use Peatland here as the way to tap, other than they're just trying to grow Death Shadow, where they could have used a Blood Crypt and then they can use Peatland to draw. They've got double fetch land here. I don't see a reason they should be using this to cast anything. All right. Full information so far. Nothing to be super afraid of. The only thing I could see is maybe they can now have two Lightning Bolts for Blood Crypt. I just think they should cash this in, try to draw and play two spells. But I'm not a player like this, so. Attack for two, pass turn. Cool. Not going to try to pick that up or anything. We've got the bonus Snapcaster here. All right. What's next? A Thoughtseize, huh? Let's go ahead and counterdraw. Let's get a little deeper here. A little counterdraw here. It taps us out here. They can use Peatland this turn if they want to. Appears my opponent's not interested in that. Creeping Tar Pit's not bad to see here. Pass the turn, we got Snapcaster Drown the Lock available. When will they cycle Peatland? Verdant Catacombs cracked here. Overgrown Tomb. Verdant Catacombs number two cracked. And a Stomping Ground. Are we gonna cycle? Yeah. I like it, opponent. Nicely done. Nicely done. Okay, a little Swift Spear. Trying to bait out the Lightning Bolts. No can do. We'll see where they go ahead and with this Aether Gust. They bottom the card. Anything else? Tarmogoyf looks fine. Top of the library is a... Oh. Is that all? We'll just pass the turn here and just probably plan to do... We might just do like... I hate to do Snapcaster Opt. Oh. Well, I guess I'm consuming now. I guess we'll consume. Hi. Hello, opponent. My name is Consume the Meek. Welcome to the party. Okay. It is time to get aggressive here and win this game now. Snapcaster into Inquisition here to steal one of the Lightning Bolts. We have the other Snapcaster here that can defend. Or we can use this other Snapcaster to... for a future spell of some sorts. All right, so all empty here. Top decks for each. No surprise here with the double bolt. We finally got that all out of hand. Good to go. So we're doing this because now I can boot up Creeping Tar Pit. They get a turn here where they could do something, but I have Drown the Lock to just remove whatever they do play. All right, let's go ahead and pick up a spell here with a Mystic Sanctuary. I'm gonna pick up a Cryptic Command. I'm gonna go ahead and boot up Creeping Tar Pit and see if my opponent wants to attack this in any fashion. Go ahead, opponent. I'm getting free Vampiric Tutors. If you say so. You know what? Let's not get greedy here. 1, 2, 3. I feel awkward here. I should be doing this differently. I don't know how to close a game properly. Not a blue mage. Let's go ahead and drown this. Okay, maybe this closes the game out. There we go. Finding the other land so that I can keep up a Cryptic Command. We'll attack for 5 here, past turn. I've got Cryptic Command to defend our creatures. Looking pretty solid here. Looking like we're gonna go 4-1 here with the list. Blue-black Titan. 4-1 here in Modern, taking it down. Losing only to that Euro Titan list. Or Euro Titan list, as some would say. I'm pretty happy, pretty stoked. A little 4-1. It's a sweet little bit list. We've revisited this list. We had the previous version. Coming back to it, I'm pretty happy with the things that are happening here. Let's just talk about really this curve briefly. It's interesting. It's also interesting to be playing 23 lands, but it seems to be working. Maybe a 24th would be good. Jace, Mirror Mage. We're treating this more times than not as a 5-drop. If we can slot it in right between our 4 and our 6-drop, that is where this goes. We basically are devoid of 3-drops. The time that we got to kick this and just go to town, the value was crazy. I know why Liliana Last Hope is here. It's like an extra win condition, kills little things. Kind of want another Jace. Kind of want another Jace. It was pretty cool. Grave Titan did well. Trenchard Gearhulk was decent. It had its places. Frost Titan wasn't a bad thing to be bringing in as well. If you're not playing the Jace, you could probably play a Frost Titan. If you're not playing the Frost Titan or the Jace, you can probably just get like another counter interactive spell. Maybe Liliana. Maybe a main Bork Ashiok or something. Yeah, we only lost to 3-3s, and it's because I took out the Fatal Pushes, but I wasn't going to have Fatal Push against Uros, Zombies, and a Primeval Titan, but we didn't even see Primeval Titan. That was our only loss, though. Grave Titan's doing things. If you want to play Grave Titan and you're sick of Amulets, you're sick of Primeval, this is your list. Blue-black, Grave Titan, in Modern.